Baby dedications. What's the point? Next on the Metal Pulpit. Thanks for joining me. Another Metal Pulpit. And yeah, that's the question I want to ask. What's the point of a baby dedication? Now, a baby dedication is something a lot of churches do. It's when a baby's born and mom and dad or mom brings the baby forward to the church for the pastor to do a dedication service. And I've done a lot of these before. And it's not the same as baptism. We don't sprinkle with water or anything like that. But it's nonetheless a time where parents take a few vows saying they'll raise their child in the way of the Lord. They'll incorporate the church, and the church then stands, and we ask the church, do you plan to do your part to help raise this child and godly instruction and help the parents? And the church replies, I do. And this is a symbolism. This is something that we read about in 1 Samuel, where Hannah presents Samuel to the Lord. Mary does the same thing in Luke chapter 2, verse 22. And we use the scripture from Psalms that says, children are a gift from God. And there's a bigger issue here, though. I do a lot of baby dedications. A lot of pastors do a lot of baby dedications. And I would say the percentage is very small as to those that stick to the pledges and the vows they take. Now, I realize a lot of people, or some people watching this video, may tune this out right away thinking it's a church thing. Follow me on this, because I think this exposes something bigger of the heart. When a parent comes up and says, we want you to dedicate our child to the Lord, I love that. I love doing it. In fact, I have a lady that makes little homemade quilts. We give it to the parent for the baby, symbolic stuff and of a special day for the baby and the parents. But what I've found to be true more times than not is that the parents that present their children to the Lord, there's a good percentage of them that don't stick to any of the vows. Okay, they don't necessarily raise them in the ways of the Lord. And how do I know this? Because there's no talk about Bible studies or devotionals or prayer or these sort of things. And especially I know this to be true because a lot of them bail on the church. And I'm not just speaking of my church, but church in general, because you can see their hashtag Sunday Funday posts. And so they aren't really following through on the pledges that they made. And so this is just really all they're looking for as a Kodak moment, a sweet little heart melting moment where we dedicated so-and-so into the Lord, but there's no follow through. You see, this is indicative of a bigger problem going on in Christianity. We want things, we want to do things, we post memes, we say, oh, I love A.W. Tozer, oh, I love a Charles Spurgeon quote, I love C.S. Lewis, and then we get down to the conversation of, oh, well, what did you read by Charles Spurgeon? Oh, you just quoted A.W. Tozer. What? Tell me what you like about A.W. Tozer. In fact, tell me about the book that you love best about A.W. Tozer. You see, there's no follow through in Christianity today. There's a small remnant of people that follow through and they read, they study, they're discipling, they're being discipled and all of these things. But, you know, at the end of the day, it's much easier to post a quote by C.S. Lewis than it is to actually read something by him. It's much easier to say, I went to church on Sunday, but there's no follow through on what are you doing during the week to be discipled. Because quite honestly, and I say this openly, very few people remember the pastor's sermon. I give one every week. I have one. I have for just about the past 22 years. And I can say confidently, very few remember the sermon from Sundays. We're all about image control in Christianity. And when we're doing this for the image, when we're doing this to throw up on social media for us to have the pictures, for us to say, look, little so-and-so, you were dedicated this day, but we don't go to church. We don't do anything that we took a vow on. It ends up ruining people. It ends up hurting people. And the world's seen enough of the phoniness. And so when people ask me to do their wedding, when people ask me to do their baby dedications, I ask them this question from here on out. I've asked this question a lot of times in my weddings that I perform, but I'm just going to ask this even more with baby dedications. I'm going to ask this: do you go to church? If they say yes, great. If they say no, I'm going to ask the next question: do you believe in God? If they say yes, great. If they say no, I'm going to ask them the next question, and that is: if you don't go to church and maybe believe in some of the things of God, why would you want the church to be part of one of your biggest days, i.e. the wedding or a baby dedication? Gives them something to think about. People are looking for something that's real in Christianity. And when we say we want to dedicate our baby unto the Lord, but we don't follow through with church, we don't follow through with devotions at home or discipling our kids or any of that, what's it for? It's a waste of time. Shoot me your thoughts, your questions, PastorBobAdams@gmail.com. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Have a great day.